Oh man, we are cooking with Kyle today big time, and we're whipping up a classic watch party favorite. No Super Bowl spread is complete without a queso dip, is it? And our buddy Kyle has one going here. It's a hearty, cheesy dip, and it's enhanced with the version of the classic Velveeta. You say it's easy to make and guaranteed to be a champion.
I promise you, this will score.
Well,
this
it'll score. Tell us more.
Okay, well, I've jumped ahead, and you know, I want you to know that, that I'm not necessarily a big fan of Velveeta, but when it comes to the Super Bowl, it sort of goes hand in hand.
It's
like a national thing.
Yeah.
All right, so we've started with what is in our pot is a big brick of Velveeta and about 8 ounces of cream cheese.
Okay.
We've melted that. To that, we have added the typical Rotel,
or it can also,
any of the diced tomatoes and green chilies will work.
Okay.
And some of the sizes are a little bit bigger. They'll come in 15 ounces. Now, here comes where I may have to have security walk me to the car because there are going to be a couple of people that are going to be very irritated.
Uh-oh.
Okay. Now, I'm sorry for Leslie, and I'm sorry for Jenny, but I'm giving away Campbell's cream of mushroom soup goes in this.
Now, who are Leslie and Jenny?
They're the people that kind of maybe tipped me off to this little ingredient. But anyway, we have done this in the slow cooker, but you can actually do it in the oven. And really, if you put it in like a casserole, cover it and put it at about 200 degrees, that works just as well. And we want it to get smooth and melted.
Yeah.
I have added all of those ingredients. And to this, we've taken a pound of sausage.
Yes.
It looks, you can see I've cooked it fairly fully.
You and crumbled it.
I've crumbled it, and I've really heavily cooked it because it will soften as it goes in there. We've also added to this sausage a small to medium-sized chopped onion and then a small bell pepper chopped, and we've sauteed that in.
Okay.
And I don't know if you can really get it on camera, but they're almost caramelized, so that's really where we want them. We're going to go ahead and add that into our dip. And addition, this is kind of a couple of Kyle additions here, we are going to go a little further, and we're going to add a little garlic powder, about a teaspoon. Go ahead and glob it in there, if you would. And then we're adding also a little bit of cumin and chili powder, about a teaspoon each.
Okay.
And that gives it a little extra kick. And that can be made in advance, easily rewarmed.
Right.
And I promise you, people will
tear it up
entirely. Now, I will also tell you, I prefer kind of like a fondue, the toast points to the
chips.
Traditional chips.
Yeah.
But that's just my preference. But I think we look good.
Yeah, I think we look real good here.
There you go.
And how much time do we have? Because we're going to try it here. Oh, okay, we got more time.
We got more time.
Okay.
All right.
All right.
So shall I schluck some in a bowl for
absolutely.
You?
Absolutely.
Now, the weather department had first dibs.
Oh, they did?
They did.
That sounds like something Mike would do.
Yes, there you are. Give it a shot and see what you think.
All right, let's try this.
If he hates it, he can't really say anything.
Mm.
Not
that
bad.
Not bad.
So this is my variation on the Super Bowl classic queso dip.
Now, you know, it is really good with that toast, too. You're right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, a little bit like a fondue.
I haven't had it with the toast, but it's really good.
A little like
a
fondue.
Can you come to my house and make that someday?
You know, I probably could do that. We could make it now, and it'll last till Sunday,
too.
That's the idea. Maybe you should take this.
Kyle, we appreciate you. As always, you can find Kyle's recipe on our website at KFOR.com. Try it and get it ready for your Sunday Super Bowl. You are going to love it. It is so good.